Welcome to EliteRugbyCoaching.com.
So that's the first type of clean out. The second type of clean out, if they're too low and they can't get their shoulders underneath, what would you suggest, George?
So you've got to remember that when you're a take clean out person, you've got all the momentum going forward. So that initial hit that you do make on the guy that is attacking the ball is going to off-sell him somehow. So it's making sure that you do capitalise on that little moment of unsettled, I guess, stability there, and then moving in a different position. So sometimes we call it a crock roll, where you utilise, if you do fail in getting underneath him, you do get one arm underneath him and then roll with the player to whichever side that you feel favourable.
Sure.
Utilising your hips in that movement, so you have like a whiplash sort of movement, and you capitalise on that moment of instability.
Of his weakness, yeah.
Once a ball is released from the, whether it's from the number six jumper here, off the top or down and fed, I'm keeping my eyes focused on the number nine there, not allowing him to get on the inside, but pushing up and using my peripheral vision, the number 10, and making sure that he's staying connected to me. So I'm moving up, one through the ball to nine, I'm moving up, staying on the inside of the nine, but being aware that the back lifter here can interrupt my line of sight with my 10. I don't want that to happen, because once I lose my connection with my 10, then I don't have that confidence to keep him pushing up. Once he has passed, then I'm able to push and either take the 10 or look for the switch on the inside, and then that person becomes
my man. That switch runner becomes your guy.
Yep. And then you have the back of the line out here taking the 9.
Filling in the space.
So it's always, everyone's covering their inside. The inside gate's always shut.
Best players I've played alongside would be Stephen Larkin. He's one of them. I've had the privilege of playing alongside him for a number of years with the Brumbies and the Wallabies, and the things that you see him do on the training paddock are quite exceptional, and then they're not really truly displayed there on the field, but you do see a number of glimpses of it when he is playing. But you know, he's a player that I think is one of the best.